The proposal for the new Care Blair Hospice focuses on improving the quality of life and dignity until the very end. It is located on Bramalia Road in Brampton, Ontario, and the neighborhood surrounding it is currently under development, which presents a lot of opportunities. As we can see in our context plan, a key element of the site is its adjacency to the Greenbelt. It has been proven that exposure to a greater wealth of plant species improves mental well-being. Having access to wooded environments such as our site can decrease anxiety, anger, confusion, depression, and fatigue. It is even more effective for people with higher initial stress levels. For that reason, I pushed the building to the very edge of the property line. By planting native trees, bushes, and ground covers in the buffer zone, we are able to extend the microclimate of the Greenbelt and create an immersive experience. I'm also suggesting planting more trees beyond the property line if allowed by the conservation authorities. It was very important to me to respond directly to the site and its surroundings. At a macro level, the neighborhood we are in is primarily residential, especially taking into consideration the new residential development across the street. For that reason, I consider the materiality, the landscaping, the scale of the building, and the shape of the roof to work in harmony with what's already existing. In terms of design, my concept revolves around the idea of passage. My approach does not consider death as an endpoint, but rather the transition between life and the afterlife. Through its form and spatial organization, the hospice embraces this journey and facilitates the process for residents and their loved ones. The building is separated into two components, the residence and the public spaces. The connecting point represents a threshold and offers views and access to a garden. It is an opportunity to pause, reflect, and appreciate the in-between. Separating the building also allows for more privacy and reduces negative distractions such as unwanted sounds and smells. The diagram here shows the evolution of the form and how I broke down the building and adjusted the shape to fit the surrounding context. We will first look at the residence. The residence suites were paired to break down the institutional feel. The small module would have a unique color to facilitate wayfinding and promote individuality. The corridor adjacent to the room was made larger to accommodate for seating and informal gathering outside of the bedroom. The bedrooms are all oriented towards north to allow for views of nature and prevent overexposure to direct sunlight. There's an overhead patient lift connecting directly to the bathroom. This allows to safely move residents around. The bedroom has a lot of storage space for personal belongings, allowing for a more personalized experience. The bedroom also includes a clear story window, allowing the south sunlight to glide through during winter months. Light represents life on Earth and the afterlife and is a symbol of hope. The integration of lighting strategies in areas of care and grief allows for a poetic and spiritual expression of the concept of passage. The bedroom opens up to a covered outdoor patio that extends to the limits of our property line to offer even more opportunities for views and gathering in the beautiful natural environment. In between residence suites units are family rooms, including a kitchenette for family members staying for a long time. In residence are also the soil utility and clean supply rooms for easier access for staff. Their nursing station is centrally located and includes a lounge room and outdoor patio for nurses. Thank you. The public spaces are located at the front of the building. The great room is adjacent to the reception area and includes a fireplace and TV to create positive distractions and give a home-like feel to the space. As requested, I also included a multi-sensory room in that area. There also are two washrooms, one universal and one accessible. All washrooms in the building are wheelchair accessible. The admin area is composed of private offices, shared office, and counseling rooms. To maximize space, I created one multi-purpose room to accommodate all activities requiring a large meeting space. In this area is the staff entrance. Upon arrival, there is the coat storage and staff area. The basement is mostly for mechanical, electrical, and back of house. I also included staff washrooms as well as a change room, staff storage, and a shower. The back of house portion includes laundry, linen storage, and assembly, the central storage, and I also included a separate area for food storage and a walk-in freezer. Overall, the net area of the building is 1,395 square meters with a gross floor area of 1,900 square meters. This results in a 73% efficiency. I also conducted an estimate of the hard cost based on data from the 2022 Canadian Cost Guide. For this building, the cost could go up to $10.4 million. The construction of the building will be in mass timber. The exposed roof and columns will give an overall warmer feel to the building. All residence units are all standardized in terms of structural system. This is what concludes the presentation. We will close with images showing how it all comes together. Thank you. Let me up.